day they were saved by a hero named Hulk. A bold adventure spanning both sides of the veil. I knew a champion, we traveled far and wide. We saw so many wonders roving side by side. In the streets of Kirkwall we brought help to those in need. Word had spread so quickly of our dealings and our deeds. Fight for your values and fight for your friends. Fight through this blight, find the light at the end. Through the age of the dragon, the people will talk of the day they were saved by a hero. To the deepest roads we ventured in the black. If we had only known what we were bringing back. We felt the fire of every temper, every mage. Caught in the crossfire of their politics and rage. Had to pull some strings and get them off each other's backs. There was a much greater danger waiting to attack. Fight for your values and fight for your friends. Fight through this blight, find the light at the end. Through the age of the dragon, the people will talk of the day they were saved by a hero. Your champion arrived. Round shores of Ferelden fade to Kirkwall's buzzing hive. Rose above the poverty and rose above the pain. My friend became the savior of the white city of chains. Fight for your values and fight for your friends. Fight through this blight, find the light at the end. Of the dragon, the people will talk of the day they were saved by a hero named Hulk. Hulk, 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 Hulk,
All right, back in Nightingale here. Oop, not what I wanted to do. All right, so I am currently building the new house. What I wanted to do was put myself near water so I can combine some fishing and farming. So there's the basic structure of it, once I get the resources I need, and then we'll do the stairs to the second floor up here. I can use this for my storage area, and then back here, we've got a little fishing hole, and I can put plant boxes around there and leave myself, well, first of all, some shade so I can fish without dying. But also I can put things in here like a simple mortar machine to get seeds, some storage for seeds and fish that I've caught and the like. But so that's the basics of it. I've got awnings out, so I probably could cover the stairs, but not worth it. But that is where we are now. So what do I need? I need fiber and I need sticks. So let's head down to the water. And it's not fiber. Okay. Collect those later. The one problem with this is that this is about 1,000 meters from home. So transporting everything I need is going to be interesting. Sticks. It's that weird tree ant creature. Okay, I actually think I have enough. At least enough for this part of it. I need a lot more stone. That's the problem with doing the stone buildings. It actually would have been nice if I had the desert set, because I could have done this out of the desert stone. Let's see if I've got enough for everything here. Okay, I got my awnings up. All right, so all I need is a lot of stone. How many do I need? Come on, I need 24 stone blocks. All right, wolf hunting stone. It's nice that I've got some ores right here. Oh, that's not what I want. That's what I want. Didn't get the whole thing. Yeah, maybe I did get the whole thing. Some more in here, but not a lot of stone. That's good. I'm going to need access to some easy ore shortly anyway. Oh, damn you. Die. least they die easy. May have enough. I have 27. I do have enough. Disassemble that building up there for some wood, which I'm going to need for the next step. And I'm thinking of wood, so I can do storage under the stairs. And then I'm thinking building the workshop here. These two walls heading out that way. I believe I gave you some wood. I did give you some wood. Okay, we're gonna give you half of these back. Gonna give you more of those back. Did pick up some of the advanced stuff. Thought I had put a window there. Got almost all of them. Oh, good. I need wood. Come here, Nanny. Where are you going? What is weighing me down? Wood bundle is weighing me down.
And I fucked the devil out your mother last night. There's no need for an exorcist.
Okay.
I've got the time. Don't open the doors at the first
now. Put a roof on here.
I don't wanna wear my clothes
when I need a couple more walls.
It's a beautiful day.
There's a good wall there. There's
a
good wall there. Good wall there.
Take
Peak Roof. And I need a gable end. Where is it? There it is. Nope, wrong one. All right. So I need more wood. There we go. Sticks, wood, and fiber. All right, but for now, I need to rest. How late is it? 6. Oh, I still need to rest. Oh, get a long rest. Get out of my bed. See what we got here. Oh. I got some sticks. I have no more regular wood. I know I've got a ton of fiber. That doesn't weigh me down too much. And then once I dismantle this and start transporting this over, which will actually be the easier part. Let's eat before I leave. What I'll do is I'll build a new respite point. And one of the neat things about moving like moving a chest, you can fill a chest up, pick it up, and then while you've got it in your hand, you can fast travel to your respite point. So it'll make actually moving the house easier. I just need the first part of this built. I may have to go after a couple of these guys because I'm gonna need wood. Oh, actually, I don't. I've got enough wood. And everything else I can just dismantle. This is the hard part about moving that far, is I can only fast travel in one direction. So I gotta run the other way. Oop, my lights a little bright. Wrong way. Here we go. That's better. I'm not glaring as much. I'm trying to remember. I think I get the crude desert set in the herbarium realm. And it's just going to be a little annoying to rebuild that, because when I when I destroy a piece, it destroys the pieces above it. So I can't just... I gotta look into it. I don't think I can just, like, replace one piece at a time. I basically gotta replace a whole vertical column. I left the door open. That was a mistake. Hey, all right. So we got the basic house built. All right. And I need some wood. So we're just going to dismantle this building up here for that. Oop, wrong one. Missed a piece. All right, you. Huh. Ah, okay. That I was able to remove. That's weird. Couldn't figure out why I couldn't get the umbrella up. Come back, collect this. Because I'm going to need a bunch of lumber. Lumber, and I need ingots. I should have ingots. I thought I made a bunch. Yeah, I got 74 tin. So I have enough. Oh. She has all my wood. What is this one? Tier 1 wood. Nice. Come on, you can make it. Figure I'll break about half of this down into lumber. I need to make more chests. I'm running out of space. number. Okay, so we'll make 20 of those. Let's start the fire. Wow, I'm still weighed down. Takes care of that. Let's wow. All right, we'll put this in with food for now. And these are more mats. Okay. All right. Well, that was fast. Not food. Half of those over. Ten of those. I think it was hinges I needed. Oh no, it's ingots. Just gonna place those down here. So that'll be for all of that stuff. Now, five stone blocks and 20 rocks. First step is eat, since I'm almost out of food. And these are going to be the worst part because I can't break these down. Well, I can break him down. I got to break him down with tools. I can't dismantle them. Which means I also need to I need to make new realm cards for them. At least I do get the synchronous lotus back. I don't get all the other materials, but I get the synchronous lotus. So once I get this new estate cairn made, then this becomes opposite. I have to do this long run back to the original spot, and then I can teleport here, but that's better than having to like haul a chest all the way over. I'm glad those guys are passive because they're huge. I also need to start hunting down I need to hunt down some of the legendary creatures, but I think I want my pistol before I do that. Now what I want to see is if I could put, I may not be able to put the cairn inside. There's anybody's I want to put it. I may be able to put it upstairs, but we'll put it out here. My respite point is now set to that. I can go destroy the other one. And I don't have it marked. I just need to be able to know where I'm heading. Fortunately, I can't give my companion a chest to carry. But I think in the beginning, what I'm going to do is just give her stuff. So kind of like the the parts for the bed and the lights and things like that. Although I will be putting up better lights, because I now have some of the better sconces. They provide more light. I also will probably build a Realmic transmuter over by my estate somewhere. Just so I can quickly change out cards, because like I would like the angler when I'm fishing. The harvest card. And once I break the house down, I'll have plenty of resources to build my workshop. Alright, let's start off with breaking these down. Since I am in shade right now. Swing and a miss. Come here. Oh, nice. I saved some of my wire out of that, too. Good. All right. So first, we are going to break that down just to get that out of the equation. Break these down. For some of the heavy stuff to her. And we will put some of this. That's potions. Oh. Put some of those into chests, because I'm going to break these down. And now, those go back in there. All right, so let's start breaking down upstairs. I think that's all my light. everything up here. Put that over there. We're going to break down all the tools and we're going to place them all into one chest. You down here where you're more convenient. And I put it in the wrong spot. Okay, let's rename this so I know what it is. Turn the caps off. All right, you are ready to move. All my lights off here. This one. Put you in there. I may end up with some chests that I didn't intend. That's all right. Hey, Gingy.
Hi, Barbie.
How you doing? Just in the middle of moving house. Oh, Adam, how are you doing? Thanks very much for the follow. So I was cruising around YouTube last night and somebody had put a video up with a great idea. Wrong trust. With a great idea to combine a small farming plot. Yeah, I'm loving Nightingale. So far, it's my favorite of the survival games. But, yeah, I saw a plan to combine a farming plot with a fishing hole. But in order to do that, I kind of needed to be near water. Luckily, not what I wanted. R. Start moving these because I don't know if it's going to destroy these when I. Actually, are these empty? Okay, those two are empty. I can break those down. Yeah, so I like the idea. I've got the basic part of the building built. And then kind of ran out of supplies. But I'm at the point where I can start moving all of this. Now, luckily, when you're dealing with your own stuff here, except for your manufactured portals, you can just break these down. So, and you get all the resources back. With the portals, you can't do it. It won't let you break down the portals. And then I just got to transport all of these chests one at a time, which is the annoying part. Okay, let's break this down. That should get rid of the chests or the shelves. Actually, those. Just to make life easy. Going to dump all of these into a chest. I may be able to do it in one chest. Hold on to that, because I may need another chest. Actually, I don't think I will. I think I can. I have enough space elsewhere. I'll just have to rearrange a little bit. Actually, no. Where I got some space. I got some space in here. These down. Put you in here. All right. Okay, that worries me. I just lost a chest. I just lost a chest full of stuff. Oh, so anyway, I can show you the house. I gotta put lights up yet, but that's the front part of the house. My respite is there, or my estate cairn is there. These two walls are going to get knocked out. My workshop is going to get built out in that direction. And then back here, I've got my little fishing hole, some shade so I can fish without burning to death. I can put my plant plots over here, some storage. And then this is actually all I need for fishing. It's just a 2x1 square. So fishing is difficult, but fish are a really good source of food. And speaking of food, I wish that chest was there. What do you have on you? It's all the realm stuff. Stairs. So you gotta put the bed over here. Need lumber, hide, and plant fiber. Come here. Okay, I've got the lumber. No hide and no plant fiber. Did she just put lumber in there? She did. All right, now for the big run back. And you can only have one fast travel point. and that's back to your home, or back to your respite, actually. So, moving house like this requires... I am so glad they're passive. Moving house like this requires running in one direction and then you can fast travel in the other. And I've modded this realm right now to increase my travel. It's a realm card called the Thinned Veil. And what it does is reduces the stamina cost for gliding. It increases my jump height. And it increases my gliding distance. So it also increases my sprint. And what was the other thing? Oh, and I don't take any falling damage. So really helpful when you when you're climbing up some of these high towers. So, and then I've got to make myself a fishing rod. I just kind of wish I had seen that video before I built my whole house. Because this is just annoying. But I put it here in the beginning because this is where there was a Fae portal. And you don't get the recipe to make a portal for a while. So I needed a portal to use. All right. I want to do raw mats. That's food. Okay, she just put something in the trunk. What do I need for the bed? Hide and plant fiber. Oh, so I want to grab my raw mats. This should be it. Yeah. Okay, well, at least the trunk showed up. Which means the other trunk is here, I just can't see it. So I think I gotta travel back. Actually, I may not have to travel back all the way. I just may have to get far enough that the house derenders. Because the problem is once I run out of energy, my stamina goes way down. Let's see if that's far enough. It's not far enough, then I'll just go. Actually, I can do that now. Grab some fiber, grab some sticks, and just make myself a bedroll. Should have enough. Nope, I need more sticks. Oh, my ad thing. Yeah, I needed to come up with some kind of ad notice. Oh, actually, I'm talking. You can't hear me because the ads are still running. Oh, I need the hide. Damn it. Okay. At least I can get her. Oh, Twitch Turbo. Okay. Yeah, I needed to get some kind of ad notice up there. I've been trying for a while. Streamer Bot has a trigger that will detect when an ad starts, so I don't need to set it on a timer. So, like, if I manually start an ad, it'll kick off automatically. Actually, let's he didn't. Because it's funny when they jump. I love that you can glide with the umbrellas. And actually there's better ones. I will be getting rid of this umbrella fairly soon. Trying to remember what realm I get the next one at. It may have been in the Astrolabe Realms. But I like the flailing when you jump. There's also another realm card called a Trickster. Which I have it on my other save. I haven't played with it yet, but I saw somebody using it. And it lets you jump really high. Like 10 times what I can do here. I don't know if it does anything for stamina. I haven't looked at the card yet. I just picked it up. But, but it'll probably let you glide farther. But I don't think it it does anything to reduce your stamina costs. Oop, I need food. Wondering when my stamina all of a sudden went low. Okay. Back, I'm more comfortable in first person. Let's move that one. Now my other chest should be showing up in the middle of the floor. Yep, there it is. What time is it? Oh, it's only 4:30. I got time. I should have eaten. Get into some shade here. Okay. Now that my stamina is back up to full. And I have to do this trip like 6 more times. I hear crickets. I also have some potions that'll help me in the desert. I pick up potions and don't even look at what they are. And I was going through my inventory and there is a potion. I gotta see how long it lasts. That will basically covers your body in frost, which makes me immune to heat damage for a little while. That would be really helpful when I'm caught like out here fighting something. You can't always find shade. Well, it is, except for you know, things like if I take the umbrella away, I guess the sun's going down enough. Like during the day, you'll see a heat bar building up. If you don't have shade, which the umbrella counts as shade, yeah, you just start building up heat. And if you're in the middle of a fight, if you get into the middle of a fight out in the sun, it's not fun when the ground... Oh. I was going to say, why is there a hammer just floating? I want to try something. Nope, that didn't count. All right, what time? Oops. But, yeah, this game is very, very detailed. As far as, like, I've got the... You know, not only do you have the realm, you can change it a little bit once it's been made. Like, I've got the Thin Veiled card, which gives me the extra jumping and traveling distance, the gliding distance. There's another one if you're farming for certain mats called the Blood Moon. What it does is it basically makes it night and there's a creature that you come across a lot called the Bound. And it basically just starts spawning bound at you. I saw somebody wanted a test to see what the card did. And as soon as they activated the card, they didn't even have time to get off of the transmuter. And luckily they were playing with two of them. And they just got attacked by several waves of bound. They didn't have to move. But on top of that, the air itself is removing like one hit point a second. So not only are you taking damage from the creatures you're fighting, you're taking damage just from the air around you. Since they weren't sure what this card was going to do, they had another card prepared so that they could change it back really quick. Just realized I don't think I have any. Yes, I do have torches. Okay. Let's get the torches up here. I have a feeling I'm going to need a torch to find my bed. Ooh, okay. Yeah, it becomes night really fast here. And the bound come out in force at night. This realm shouldn't be too bad. If you get stuck at nighttime, in the higher level realms, it gets really dangerous. Although even if I get a lot of bound in this realm, they're easy enough to fight. Okay. Let's move that. Luckily I can fast travel. Put that down there. That's just light enough for me to see. I also like the building with blueprints. That's nice. And like I've got right now, I've just got the crude set with some advanced pieces. Like I've got these picture windows, which I didn't have in the last set. I just picked these up. But there's a desert set, which looks really nice. I just don't have it yet for this playthrough. There's a tutor set, a pagoda set. They're talking about adding more. And you can mix and match them. You know, like I've got over here, I've got crude stone and crude wood. But in my other save, when I moved the house, my other save is in a forest realm. But when I moved the house, I made it out of the desert set, and it looks so nice. And then there's advanced pieces with different patterns on the walls. Just thinking of what do I need to put in. I need to build my workshop space and lay out all my workshop tools. I picked up some new augments. I've got to build those. Need to find some desert caves, which means I will probably be traveling to a my first portal is probably going to be to a desert Astrolabe realm, because I need copper. I have not found any copper on this map. But I need copper so that I can make my pistol. I really want the pistol for fighting. I need to get firearms. Because I've got the sling bow, but it's not It's not super accurate at distance. I'm so glad I can fast travel with a chest in my hand. Oh, I need food. So, and there's also different levels of resource. You know, like even the food, there's three different types of mushrooms I've found so far. Even at this level, and they each have slightly different stats. So when you're making, like I'm just dealing with roasted meat and mixed plants. But, you know, I'm making the plant combinations for the mixed food right now to kind of boost my stamina. They all have pretty much some health boost, but I'm trying to maximize my mixed plants to boost my stamina and my stamina recovery to help with the travel. Oh, also on this save, before I was talking about exploring the ship, I got to explore one ship in my other save, and there's nothing much there until you get to the point where you have to unlock the Gloom card, and that's one of the realm majors. So the different realms in order of difficulty are the Abeyance realm, which is where we are now, and that's kind of your permanent home base. I could move to another Abeyance realm if I wanted to. And make that my home base, but these are the most gentle. So the Abeyance realms are good for your home base. And then you've got the... What's the next one? Realm cards. So you got the Abeyance, the Antiquarian, Astrolabe, yeah, that's where I am now, Astrolabe, and then you've got the Herbarium, the gloom. It doesn't really matter. Oops. X, R, M. And back again. And this is my last chest. So after this, I can start looking at making the workshop wing. And then organizing my storage. And I need to make a portal. I'm going to have to make a whole bunch of portals, but I just need to make one portal. Get to the desert realm, the desert astrolabe realm. Oh, actually, I could probably do it in the desert antiquarian. I didn't explore that much. Because right now I just need a bunch of copper so I can get my Lancaster pistol. And then I gotta look at boosting that. I also need to find the next backpack. Which I think is the Explorer's backpack. And I want to upgrade my shirt. My shirt is the only piece of clothing that I haven't upgraded, because you don't get a shirt with the drops. You didn't get a shirt. So right now I still have the basic shirt. And I'm not bothering to upgrade that one, because I know there's a better shirt coming. Alright, so last chest, and then I am done with this. Done with this spot, at least. Okay. All right, so I need stone. Now I just got to find out where I put all my stone. Here's all my stone. Oops, I don't want to move that. I want to get rid of it. Okay, and three enough? Yeah, three should be enough. All right, let's get some. We'll do the regular windows here. Put those here. Regular walls in, just so I have a place to put shelves. Yeah, and I think we just put a peaked roof in here. I need wood. Moving. Oh, that's why. I'm still in the decontamination. It's still not moving. All right, it lets me move that, but it's not letting me move. Oh. Stations. All right. Oh, I have no wood in there. I have plant fiber in there, though. And then I have lumber in there. Something tells me I'm having problems here. Come on, give me the marker. There we go. Do those out of stone. That one's going to be out of wood. Wood bundles. What am I missing? Come on, show me what I need. There we go. Oh, I need sticks. To do this the easy way. Come here, nanny. Why are you walking away from me?
Give me your hand, give me your hand.
So I need... That's not going to be enough. Okay. All right, so that's built. Sticks, fiber, I need lumber, or I gotta rebuild two walls up here. I may have to log out and log back in because I'm getting some. Oh, let's get the hide. That one copied over. Okay. Where is my crude wall? Here we go. Crude solid wall. That's the workstations. There we go. Okay, she made that one. But why is it not letting me... Not letting me place a wall here. Something is blocking it. Oh, I didn't want a wall there. I am going to log out and log back in. Actually, it's almost time for my break, so I will take my break a little bit early while I reload the game. because I think I'm going to exit all the way out, because this is just beginning to act weird on me. So hang out, I'll turn the music up, and I will be back shortly. All right, I'm back, but I think I'm going to have to end stream early because I mean, all my chests are missing. I can't access them. I was able to, actually, I know the chests are there because she completed these parts for me. But I've shut down twice and restarted. You can also see the tests are here because I'm bumping into them. Those are where all the chests were. There should be one here. Yep. You can see where I kind of stutter when I hit them. But early access game, you know, crap like this happens. So unfortunately, we got the house built. At least. But, like, I can't get the dog back. I can't build any of my lights. I can't build my workshop, which I kind of need at this point. Because all my supplies are in here somewhere. But, yeah, it, like I said, it's an early access game. Crap like this is going to happen. This is the first major problem I've had. Even the, you know, getting kicked off the server while I'm trying to transfer realms, that's even not as much of a hassle as this is right now. But, yeah, so I think I'm going to give up on Nightingale for today. Hopefully by Monday this will be fixed. And we continue on then. If it does get fixed over the weekend, yeah, usually the buggiest games are the best games. At least they're not treating it like Cyberpunk was. I mean, this game is very playable. You know, so at least we're not dealing with what Cyberpunk went through. So I will hop onto the Discord, see if this has been reported. If they fix it over the weekend, then over the weekend I will get the workshop built. I'll get the rest of this place decorated out. So that we can go right into realm hopping on Monday. But Monday is not my next stream. We will be back on tonight, starting between 9 and 9:30 Eastern, with my D&D group, Storm King's Thunder. Let me snooze the ad. So tonight will be my next stream, and then Monday we'll be back in on this. Other than that, sorry about having to cut this short, but it happens. But I hope you guys had fun watching, and I hope to see you guys back again on Monday.